Hi everybody, Alex Deployer here from Expert Forex, and in today's video I'm going to give you a couple of tips on how to improve the performance of your computer. Now, why is that important in Forex trading? A lot of Forex traders use EAs on their computers, or very resource intensive indicators. The actual MT4 platform does consume quite a lot of resource and it can slow your computer down. I do a lot of one-on-one Forex trading sessions on other people's computers using TeamViewer, and I'm quite amazed at how slow some of the computers are and how badly they've been maintained in terms of their performance. And it really is a 10 minutes exercise to improve the performance of your computer. So I'm going to take you through the process that I use. By no means is this an expert type of presentation. This is what I do. If you don't find similar functionality on your computer, just Google it. And that's what I do. If I get stuck, I just Google anything and you'll be amazed at the information that you get. So the first thing is to look at what your current situation is. And on your screen, you'll see the Windows Task Master. And it is showing the performance of my current computer. I have a pretty powerful computer here. It's got 8 processors. It's got 32 RAM. So pretty powerful. But you can see a lot of it is cache. Of the 32, only 23 is available, and only 5 RAM is available as free RAM. So we're going to go through a process of trying to improve this, and this is something I do on a Saturday or Sunday when the market's closed. I recondition my computer for the next week's trading, and it does involve you rebooting your computer. And let's have a look at the process. By the way, to get your task manager, what you do is what I do, for instance, I right click on the bar at the bottom of the screen and it brings up a menu, and I click on task manager and it will open the task manager. If it doesn't work that way with your Windows version, there are a couple of basic things that you need to do. Firstly, you need to clear the cache of your browsers. Now I'll show you two ways of doing that. Firstly, on Chrome, using Chrome, what I do is I go to the right hand top menu, click on that. It then opens another menu, and then I click on history and I click on that. And then on the left hand side of your screen, on your left hand side, you'll see clear browsing data. So I'm actually going to click on that, and it says clear browsing data, all the download history, cookies, cached images, all that type of stuff. I'm actually going to do that. So I'm clearing my browsing data. You could also do that, and I'll just open Internet Explorer quickly. Here we've got Internet Explorer. What you do there is you go to Tools, Internet Options, and Browsing History is over here. You click on Delete, and it'll bring up the same type of menu over there, and you then just press Delete, and that's it. The next thing that I do, and this is the most valuable little tool that I've found, is I go into Windows Accessories and I find a program called Disk Cleanup. And I've actually got it permanently on my programs. I click on that, and this is what it says. It says Disk Cleanup. What drive do you want to clean up? And I'll say, okay, my C drive. I click on that. It then goes away and does an assessment of what's required. And now, because I've already cleaned a lot of the history up, there's very little to be cleaned up here. There's only a few bytes. And then what you do is, and normally when you delete programs out of this process, nothing is dangerous because it's deleting temporary or unused programs, and it's actually deleting your, it's cleaning your recycling bin and all kinds of good things. So I click on that and I say okay and delete the files. Right, so now my computer is pretty clean. The next process is going to be difficult because I now need to reboot my computer. So to reboot my computer, I go down to the left, the bottom left corner, click on the icon there and do the shutdown. I'm going to do that shutdown now, so our recording will stop and obviously the system will reboot, and I'll have to start a brand new recording after this particular one. So I'll see you in a very short while when my computer has rebooted. Okay, back again. I've just rebooted my computer and I have opened the task manager again and had a look at that. But as you can see, our cache is essentially clear now. And I have a huge amount. Before there was only 5,000 RAM available, now there's 27,000. So that little exercise I did really did clean my computer up. And if you don't do this on a weekly basis, these things accumulate and after a while your computer will go so slow and almost become unusable. Very important, if you're trading EAs on your computer or if you're trading Forex on your computer, do this every week on a Saturday and Sunday. And for many of you, you may not recognize your computer's performance after you've done this. So I hope you found this helpful. If there are any aspects that you're unclear about, please just Google them and you'll find them. You'll most probably find a better explanation on the internet. So from me, Alex Deploy, cheerio.